Hi guys, so I just did a pour from Mina Villegas and it came out amazing. I'm still thinking of a name for it. By the time you see it, it'll probably have a name and it'll already be up. So I'm gonna try and do that again. The problem was I didn't write down what color I did my paints and I didn't do it on camera. So this is going to be an interesting task. Because you know how it is, you can't recreate two pours. So we're just gonna wing it. I don't know what I did. I think it really matters at this point how I do it, so. Do a little white after that. This is Art Mine's Metallic Sapphire. These out of the way for now. Put these over here. Now, it's a little fuller than I wanted, but let's see what we can create. Thank you. Okay, I can breathe. All right. I do like this. It's got a little more red in it this time, or the violet in it this time than the last one. But we'll see how it goes. Let's just do that because you guys were... I'm on low battery mode. Oh no. So I'm going to take this. I'm going to stretch it out a bit. So like I did on the last one for Mina Villegas, I had to do this on the edges. You don't want your composition folding over itself. So I do this. And like I said before, in my last video, you know, you might cringe that there's a whole lot of, you think there's gonna be a lot of wasted paint, but please remember, I use Floetrol, so the majority of my waste is probably Floetrol. I can probably guarantee you I only used about 5 or 6 ounces of paint in total. So there is probably very little paint waste. But regardless, it's a waste of Floetrol, okay? But you need this. This needs to be done with this type of piece because I do not want to overstretch it, lose composition. I don't want anything getting wonky. So, give it another torch in just a second. Need a paper towel though. Stretch out nice and slowly. And back in the middle. We're gonna come this way. God, I hope you guys can see. Well, I hope I'm not fully off camera is what I mean. I know I'm gonna be partially off camera, but gonna stop right there for a minute. One's tough, so I'm gonna rotate it that way. I'm gonna do one more torch before I finish stretching. This way. The paint is definitely moving a little bit slower than it did in the beginning. I'm just bringing it back to the center. I'm going to rotate it again so I can pour towards you guys. Just bring it back to the center, guys. You're not missing anything. It's similar, but not the same. But the colors are fantastic. I love these very much, both of them. All right, so I'm gonna take my gloves off because I'm sort of done playing with the paints. And I'm just gonna use a stick to get the corners after I bring you guys in. All right. So I'm just loving all of this, and it goes down the edges. It's so beautiful. I'm not sure. I could potentially stretch it out more, but I think I'll lose a lot of the color. So this is a corner that I gotta fill in here. But it comes right down the side. Love this. It is so cool looking. So this is the final piece, guys. Thanks so much for watching. I have my social media links included in the description at the very bottom if you'd like to connect to me via those. My email address is shortly underneath the top area as well, the first few sentences. So if you want to reach out to me, you can email me directly for any sales inquiries, commissions, etc. I have a PayPal me link down below as well that you can take a look at if you'd like to donate to the arts and towards my cause of making beautiful artwork for you. So feel free to do that if you'd like. It is definitely not required. You guys can reach out to me at any point in time for questions. I do try to answer as many questions on here as possible. But I can't always get to them right away. Anywho, thank you so much for watching, guys. This is the second Galaxy Pour.